Our help is in the name of the Lord. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Good morning. As we celebrate this first Sunday of Lent, let us begin in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Lord, bless us with the wisdom to praise you in spirit and in truth, so that by following your holy will, we may gain eternal salvation. Amen. My dear brothers and sisters, let us take a moment, confess our sins to God in ways that we have failed him and our neighbor in thought, word, deed, and omission, so that we may worthily participate in this holy sacrifice. Please now make an examination of your conscience. During Lent, we will be using the first form of the Confiteor on page 66. Almighty Father, you know my deepest secrets. I confess that I have, through my own fault, sinned against your holy laws. In my thoughts, in my words, and what I have done or failed to do, I sincerely regret my sins, and I am truly sorry for offending you. I ask, Father, that in your mercy, you pardon my sins. I promise to change my way of living, so that through a deeper holiness, I may better serve you throughout the rest of my life. I ask the Blessed Virgin Mary, all the saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. For your penance, I would ask you to say to our fathers, may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. And may our Lord Jesus Christ absolve you, and with his authority vested in me, I absolve you from all of your sins in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Noah, found just and perfect, renewed the race in the time of devastation. Because of his worth, there were survivors, and with a sign to him, the deluge ended. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Lord our God, as Noah was saved in the ark while sin was drowned in the flood, so by the waters of baptism may our mortality be swept away, and may we be brought to your holy mountain. We ask this in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated for our first reading.
The first reading is from the book of Genesis. God said to Noah and to his sons with him, see, I am now establishing my covenant with you and your descendants after you, and with every living creature that was with you, all the birds and the various tame and wild animals that were with you and came out of the ark. I will establish my covenant with you, that never again shall all bodily creatures be destroyed by the waters of a flood. There shall not be another flood to devastate the earth. God added, "This is the sign that I am giving for all ages to come, of the covenant between me and you and every living creature with you. I set my bow in the clouds to serve as a sign of the covenant between me and the earth. When I bring clouds over the earth and the bow appears in the clouds, I will recall the covenant I have made between me and you and all living beings, so that the waters shall never again become a flood to destroy all mortal beings." This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please respond. Your ways, O Lord, are love and truth to those who keep your covenant.
Your ways, O Lord, are love and truth to those who keep your covenant.
Your ways, O Lord, make known to me. Teach me your paths. Guide me in your truth and teach me, for you are God, my Savior.
Your ways, O Lord, are love and truth to those who keep your covenant.
Remember that your compassion, O Lord, and your love are from of old. In your kindness, remember me, because of your goodness, O Lord.
Your ways, O Lord, are love and truth to those who keep your covenant.
Good and upright is the Lord. Thus he shows sinners the way. He guides the humble to justice, and he teaches the humble his way.
Your ways, O Lord, are love and truth to those who keep your covenant.
The second reading is from the first letter of St. Peter. Beloved, Christ suffered for sins once, the righteous for the sake of the unrighteous, that he might lead you to God. Put to death in the flesh, he was brought to life in the spirit. In it, he also went to preach to the spirits in prison, who had once been disobedient, while God patiently waited in the days of Noah during the building of the ark, in which a few persons, eight in all, were saved through water. This prefigured baptism, which saves you now. It is not a removal of dirt from the body, but an appeal of God, or an appeal to God for a clear conscience, through the resurrection of Jesus Christ, who has gone into heaven and is at the right hand of God, with angels, authorities, and powers subject to him. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory. One does not live on bread alone, but on every word that comes forth from the mouth of God.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with
you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Mark.
Glory be to you, Lord.
The Spirit drove Jesus out into the desert. And he remained in the desert for 40 days, tempted by Satan. He was among wild beasts, and the angels ministered to him. After John had been arrested, Jesus came to Galilee proclaiming the gospel of God. This is the time of fulfillment. The kingdom of God is at hand. Repent and believe in the gospel.
This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
The Spirit drove Jesus out into the desert, and he remained in the desert for 40 days, tempted by Satan. These words are taken from today's gospel according to St. Mark, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, we seem to have an echo. Have you ever just kind of sat alone in a quiet space, perhaps dark, and just been with your thoughts? It can get pretty dark inside, can't it? When there's nothing around to distract us, when there's just nothing but us, God, maybe Satan trying to tempt us into thinking things that we don't want to think about. Well, Jesus went out into the wilderness of the desert for not 40 hours, but 40 days. And he did this so that he could test the limits of his humanity before he started his ministry among the people. And it says right here in Scripture, he was tempted. That means he was fully human, just like you and me. He understands what it is to be tempted. But he resisted. And gives us an example of how to resist. And in doing that, he also was kind of strengthening himself over those 40 days. Because he knew in just a few years what was going to happen. And he himself was going to fight Satan and conquer him. But he needed to be ready. This was the beginning of his training. How much more so for us? The temptations that come to us every day, things come to us. Sometimes we can fight them off, sometimes we give in. That's why we have reconciliation. Because each time we fight, the stronger we get. When we give in, we take it to confession, receive absolution, we also get stronger. So we won't be as apt to fall into it again. The important thing is to be alert and aware of when it comes. And if we're not strong enough yet, just keep fighting. Just keep going. That is what Jesus did for 40 days. 40 days. And then, when he was done, he came back, and what did he say? The kingdom of God is at hand. Repent and believe in the gospel. That's what we're called to do as well. So during these 40 days, think of it as like a retreat in a sense. Let us just take some time, increase our prayer time. Maybe do a little fasting, maybe a little more almsgiving. And as I said on Ash Wednesday, hopefully if we follow what the church gives us, handed down from the time of the apostles, we will be a little bit better on Easter Sunday than we were on Ash Wednesday. The Spirit drove Jesus out into the desert, and he remained in the desert for 40 days, tempted by Satan. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Let us now stand and turn to page 71 and say together the creed that unites us as Christians. I believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he was born of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in fulfillment of the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord and giver of life, who proceeds from the Father. With the Father and the Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. The Lord be with you. With absolute faith in his Father, Jesus overcame temptation. With the same confidence, we lift up our own prayers of petition. Our response will be, Lord, have mercy.
For the church, that the faithful may be purified and renewed through their Lenten works of penance, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For world leaders, that they avoid temptations of power and greed and serve with sincere generosity in the Spirit of Christ, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our youth preparing for the sacraments, that they may grow in knowledge and love for Jesus and discover the channels of his divine grace, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For those who are suffering in body, mind, or spirit, especially those on our parish prayer list, that they may be brought to health and wholeness through the mercy of Christ, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our own intentions that we hold in silence, and for whom this Mass is offered, for the repose of the soul of Regina Say, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For those who have died and those who will die today, that they may experience eternal peace in the heavenly kingdom, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy. Faithful God, you never abandon those who need you. Help us to recognize your love in our daily lives and follow your holy path. We ask all these things, both spoken and unspoken, through your Son, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
God told Noah, "This is the sign of the covenant I have established between me and all mortal creatures that are on earth." Blessed are you, Lord God, all creation, taking us as bread to offer to earth is given. Human hands have made, may it become for us the bread of life. The mystery of this wine. And water, may we come to share the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, to your goodness have wine to offer, fruit of the vine, work of human hands, may it become our spiritual drink. Lord God, we ask you to receive us and be pleased with the sacrifice we offer you with humble and contrite hearts. Come, Holy Spirit, and bless the sacrifice which you have prepared for the glory of your holy name. Lord, wash away my iniquity. Cleanse me from my sin. Receive this offering, most holy Trinity, which we make in memory of the passion, resurrection, and ascension of our Lord Jesus Christ, and in honor of the Blessed Virgin Mary and all the saints. May they whose memory we honor on earth intercede for us in heaven. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your name, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy name.
Heavenly Father, make us worthy to bring these gifts to you. May this offering cleanse us from our sins and make us deserving of your Son's sacrifice. We ask this through the same Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Father, all-powerful and ever-living God, we do well always and everywhere to give you thanks through Jesus Christ our Lord. Through our fasting, you increase divine life within us. You preserve us from sin and lead us into eternal life. Through our abstinence, you confirm us in goodness and curb our unbridled vices. As we commemorate this 40-day fast of your Son, may we, together with him, give you glory. Therefore, with the angels and archangels, with all the saints and the entire church, we lift our hymn of praise to your glory, repeating unceasingly.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Holy Sacrifice of Mass continues with Eucharistic Prayer 3, which is found on page 84 if you're following along. We acclaim you, Holy Lord, glorious in power. Your mighty works reveal your wisdom and love. You have formed us in your own image, giving the whole world into our care, so that, in obedience to you, our Creator, we might rule and serve all your creatures. When our disobedience took us far from you, you did not abandon us to the power of death. In your mercy, you came to our help, so that in seeking you, we might find you. Again and again, you called us into covenant with you, and through the prophets, you taught us to hope for salvation. Gracious God, you loved the world so much that in the fullness of time, you sent your only Son to be our Savior. Incarnate by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, he lived as one of us, yet without sin. To the poor, he proclaimed the good news of salvation, the prisoner's freedom, to the sorrowful joy. To fulfill your purpose, he gave himself up to death, and rising from the grave, destroyed death and made the whole creation new, and that we might live no longer for ourselves, but for him who died and rose for us, he sent the Holy Spirit, his own first gift for those who believe, to complete his work in the world and to bring to fulfillment the sanctification of all. When the hour had come for him to be glorified, having loved his own who were in the world, he loved them to the end. At supper with them, he took bread. And when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take this, all of you, and eat it. For this is my body, which is given for you." After supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant, which shall be shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. As often as you do this, do it in remembrance of me." We now celebrate the memorial of our redemption, recalling Christ's death and descent among the dead, proclaiming his resurrection and his ascension to your right hand, awaiting his coming in glory, and offering to you from the gifts you have given us, this bread and this cup, we praise you and bless you. Together, we praise you, we bless you, we give thanks to you, and we pray to you, Lord our God. We pray that in your goodness and mercy, your Holy Spirit may descend upon us and upon these gifts, sanctifying them and showing them to be holy gifts for your holy people. The bread of life and the cup of salvation, the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Grant that all who share this bread and this cup may become one body and one spirit, a living sacrifice in Christ to the praise of your name. Remember your one holy Catholic and apostolic church, redeemed by the blood of your Christ. Reveal its unity, guard its faith, and preserve it in peace. Remember Anthony, our prime bishop, Charles, our administrator, and all who minister in your church. Remember all your people and those who seek your truth, especially those who cannot be with us today. Remember all who have died in the peace of Christ, whose faith is known to you alone, especially Regina, for whom we offer this Mass. Bring them into the place of eternal joy and light, and grant that we may find our inheritance with the Blessed Virgin Mary, with our ancestors in faith, with the prophets, apostles, and martyrs, and all the saints who have found favor with you in ages past. We praise you in union with them and give you glory through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Through Christ and with Christ and in Christ, all honor and glory are yours, Creator of all, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, forever and ever.
Amen. Page 95, let us pray with confidence to the Father in the words our Savior gave us.
It is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. The cup of blessing which we bless, is it not a participation in the blood of Christ? The bread which we break, is it not a participation in the body of Christ?
This is one bread. We who are many are one body, for we all partake of the one.
May the union of divinity and humanity in Jesus Christ bring us sanctification and eternal life.
Amen.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Do not look at our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace and unity of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also with you.
Let's offer each other a sign of Christ's peace. Let us say together the first communion prayer found on page 97. Lord Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, by the will of the Father and the work of the Holy Spirit, your death brought life to the world. By your holy body and blood, Free me from all my sins and all every evil. Keep me faithful to your teaching and never let me be parted from you. I will take the bread of heaven and call upon the name of the Lord. Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word and I shall be healed. May the body of Christ bring me to everlasting life. May the blood of Christ bring me to everlasting life. For those who are joining us online or who for personal reasons cannot receive the body and blood of Christ today, please join me now in the act of spiritual communion. Most loving Jesus, I adore you in the most blessed sacrament in which you are truly present. I love you above all things, and I long for you in my soul. Since I cannot receive you sacramentally, I ask you to come spiritually into my heart and heal my soul. I embrace you and unite myself with you. May I never be separated from you. Inflame my heart with the fire of your love, my Lord and Savior. Amen. This is the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are those who are called to the table of the Lord. Body and blood of Christ. The 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 body and blood of Christ. 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 The body and blood of Christ. Body and blood of Christ. Body and blood of Christ. Thank you. For we do not have a high priest who is unable to sympathize with our weaknesses, but one who has similarly been tested in every way, yet without sin. Let us pray. Lord Jesus Christ, you are our faithful high priest, tempted in the wilderness, so to help others who are tempted. Through this holy communion, aid, strengthen, and purify us. For you live and reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. The Lord be with you. May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come upon you and remain with you forever. Go in peace, the sacrifice is offered. Thanks be to God. Please join me now in the prayer of St. Michael. Holy Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Safeguard against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do you, O Prince of the Heavenly Host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who wander through the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. Please join me now in a prayer for peace with the prayer of St. Francis. Lord, make me an instrument of your peace. Where there is hatred, let me sow love. Where there is injury, pardon. Where there is doubt, faith. Where there is despair, hope. Where there is darkness, light. And where there is sadness, joy. O Divine Master, grant that I may not so much seek to be consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love. For it is in giving that we receive, it is in pardoning that we are pardoned, and it is in dying that we are born to eternal life. Amen. My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, thank you so much for joining us for our Holy Mass today. We pray that you have a wonderful rest of your day, rest of your weekend. Stay safe. Take care of yourselves. Take care of each other. Remain in a state of grace and fight evil wherever you find it and spread joy wherever you go.